What happens to your motivation when you're just having a bad day? How do you stay motivated? Hey, welcome to another Mic Drop Monday, where I drop you a little truth bomb to help you work harder and smarter on the week ahead. And this week I'm talking about motivation. Well, actually most weeks I'm talking about motivation, but this week I'm talking about how do you stay motivated when you really just feel very demotivated, or you're having a bad day, or things aren't going your way. How do you find that motivation to just stay positive and keep on going? And this is like, there's so many contradictory things out there. So some teachings will tell you that you have to have positive thoughts all the time. You have to be in the right mindset. And yeah, you do have to be in the right mindset, but at the same time, it's impossible to just have positive, motivating thoughts all day, because we all have bad days. We all have things that upset our day. We all have things that make us just want to go back to bed some days. We all have people in our lives that stress us out, or we all have clients to deal with that stress us out, all those different things. And at some point, you are going to get hit by a wave of negativity, and at some point, you are going to feel like not going out of bed. And some days you're not gonna feel that positive. So what can you actually do to turn that negative into a positive and actually keep yourself motivated? So, tip number one, look at how far you've come. And I know this is like a really stupid thing. Like everybody says, oh, look how far you've come, you've done so well. But actually, look at how far you've come. And little things like, do you know what I find is really, really useful? You know when Facebook reminds you of what you was doing on this day 5 years ago, or where you was, or you hear something on the news and you go, oh my God, I remember that, or I remember that day, and then actually think about what you was doing at that time. Was you doing what you're doing now? Probably not. Was you even in the same job? Was your life how you wanted it to be? All the different things. What was bad about your life then that now you actually can't even remember, like something that was bad that happened then, and you go, oh God, I totally forgot about that. Like, don't remind yourself of it to make yourself feel bad, but remind yourself of it to realize that you've got past it, and you know, life's better now maybe. So another thing is to look for those milestones, you know, when LinkedIn reminds you of how many years you've been in your current position. And like, I'm coming up to, I think it's like my 7th year now of being self-employed, and I think, oh, God, I can't even remember what it's like to work for someone else anymore. 7 years, like it's a long time to actually be working for yourself. And it's good to remind yourself of these things. So just look out for those little milestones where you can remind yourself of how far you've come. Number two. So you've probably heard of the eat the frog, which is do like your most difficult task first thing in the morning, or do the thing you're putting off, or do the thing you don't want to do. And it sets up your whole day then to be better. So eat your frog first thing in the morning. And it is a good piece of advice, but actually eating your frog, obviously not literally, please don't go around eating frogs, but eat your frog and then do something to reward yourself. So something I've started doing lately, and it's because I'm not the greatest of morning people, I'm really not. And the funny thing is, and you'll hear about this in a few weeks, because I'm doing researching morning routines to write for a blog post, but I'm really not a morning person, so it's really hard. And I literally never used to even be able to function until I'd had about 10 cups of coffee, and I couldn't leave the house until I'd, you know, totally caffeinated myself. And but now what I've started doing is, whatever that one task is that I'm really putting off and I'm not getting around to doing, and I know I really need to do it, or that email that I just don't want to reply to because it's going to be difficult, that difficult thing, my frog, I'm doing that first thing in the morning, and then like having my morning coffee or just doing my nice thing, I'm not putting it off. So I'm literally eating the frog and then rewarding myself. So I know that I have to eat my frog before I can have my coffee. Frogs are bad for breakfast, by the way. And number three, celebrate every single little win. Even if it's a case of, and I love doing this, and I have like my pretty highlighter pens all over my desk so I can do this. So I'll write out my absolutely must do's for the days. And if you've seen my goal setting blog, then you'll know about your absolutely must do's, and I will link it below as well. So do your absolutely must do's, and then find something that you like doing, whether it be just ticking them off in a red pen, like teacher style, or just like highlighting with a nice pink highlighter, whatever kind of gives you that little bit of satisfaction to celebrate that win of, oh, I did something off my to-do list, mark it off. Or whether it be you've got like nice stickers that you like to put next to your to-dos, just whatever it is, just something like a really nice little thing. But then as your wins are bigger, so if you get a new client, if you just, you know, publish a blog post, because sometimes even writing that blog post can be like, it's so difficult and I have no motivation to do this. But just doing that, and you just celebrate your little wins, even if you're just gonna tell your kids, guess what, mum published a blog post today, and they go, oh, what are you on about, I don't know what you're talking about. And they just totally ignore you, it doesn't matter. Like, just share that win, tell someone. Like, celebrate, tell yourself, go and look at yourself in the mirror and say, you're great, you did this today. But just celebrate every single little win. Achieving things within your business and getting things done is all about taking baby steps. And sometimes when we start out, or we've got a new task to do, or we're taking the business in a new direction, or just doing something, it can seem like you're looking up a mountain, you're going, oh my God, you're expecting me to climb Mount Everest and you're not even giving me the right equipment here. How am I gonna do it? But by taking tiny, tiny little baby steps every single day, and even if you have to celebrate every single little step just to get you to where you want to be, then so be it. You'll go at your own pace and you'll achieve things in your own time, but you will get there if you just take each little step and celebrate each little step. And don't think that, you know, you have to be making massive wins every day. There is no magic formula. There is no just magic button that you can press to get there and everything will get done. That's not going to happen. But celebrate every single little success and you will get there eventually. And you'll feel a little bit more motivated along the way as well. So I hope you found these steps useful and you can put them into practice on the week ahead. Just a reminder that my masterclass is now available to book on how to grow your network marketing business. So if you've just taken on an MLM and to supplement your income or to replace your full-time income, if you want to grow that business without annoying your friends and family with your constant posting on Facebook, or if you want to recruit a team and earn income from them as well, this course will really, really help you. It's a live event, it's online and live. You'll get an ebook, you'll get worksheets, you will be able to ask questions live in the training as well, and you'll be able to watch the video forevermore to pick up all the tips that will be in it. The link is below to book that. Please do, and I look forward to seeing you on it. Thank you for watching this edition of Mic Drop Monday, and I hope you found it useful. Please give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe and give it a share to someone that you think needs a little bit of motivation this week. Don't forget to follow all my other social media channels, and I will speak to you again next week.